There's an article getting a lot of play around the office today and around the industry. It's from Ad Age. It's reporting as many as 78% of some brands' influencer followers are fake, meaning this influencer content they're paying for is not reaching a real audience. Why is this happening? My guess is automation software and taking a shortcut. Using a tool to help you pick influencers is a great idea. It helps you narrow the list, but you must go in, as we do here at Carusele, and hand scrub each influencer. You're looking for fake followers, you're looking for fake engagement. Five things you can look for to spot fake engagement. Number one, one-word comments. One-word comments, often fake. Similarly, new is number two, single emoji comments. Single emoji comments are often purchased as well. Number three, people commenting from other countries. It's much cheaper to buy a group of followers from other countries than it is from the United States, so a lot of followers from other countries is something you need to look into. Number four is a sudden jump in the number of followers. It's unlikely that your influencers have skyrocketed up very suddenly like that, so making sure that that's checked out and legitimate if they did something interesting that would warrant that sudden increase. And similarly, a sudden inconsistency in the engagement rate. So if you're seeing normally with this influencer a 3% engagement rate, for example, and suddenly it's 6 or 8 or 10%, they may have been buying engagement as well. So there's a lot of things that can be automated. Hand checking your influencers both before you pick them and during the campaign is not a step you can skip. That's all I have for today. Until next time on The Spin, I'm Jim Tobin.